think the pitcher's aiming.
You got the camera.
अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावन वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णा प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौर
गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताजन यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वो तवैवास्मि न हि मामि त्वया विना भक्त्या विहीना अपराध लक्ष्य चित्तस्य कामाय कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना विन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम्
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल my millions of tender pranam in the lotus feet my paramaradha guru pad padma om vishnu pad shishma bhakti pad jnan ki and same millions of tender pranam in the lotus feet of om vishnu pad shishma bhakti vedan swami maharaj
We are discussing about Baddha Jeev, how we came in the control of Maya. And after this, how it can be liberated, and have the service of Lotus Pad Padma of Radha and Krishna. We have explained for 2 days. Now how many more days?
3 more days.
Today? And after this, 3 days. Oh, first of all, I want to tell about Govardhan Puja. Tomorrow is Govardhan Puja. In Braja, before Krishna, there was some demigods worshipping. Krishna never wanted that it should be. He wanted to check up all these things. Especially those who had pride, anyone. Oh, it should be crushed. So they were doing Indra Puja. And thinking that Indra gives rain. And by rain, grasses come. By grasses, cows and pound in water in ponds everywhere, and thus we are alive. So due to Indra, and before Indra, puja of one day before, Mother Yashoda was cooking so many various preparations. Everyone in Braj. Then Krishna asked, what Mother is doing? I went to Mother and asked, but she rebuked me, go and play with boys. So, please Father, you should tell me what she is doing. My birthday or what? Then Father told, oh, you are going to do tomorrow Indra Puja. You fight, Father? So he gives rain, he gives water, and he nourishes us. Without him, no rain, nothing. And then our cows will die, we will die. Then Krishna told, where there is no Indra Puja, or other places, if there is no rain, no grass, no they are living, no cows, why you are doing? Then Nanda Baba could not reply. Then, what should we do? Why not we should do the puja of Govardhan? Govardhan, 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 Gopi, Go, or really he gives rain. He is high, so high that cloud comes and transformed into rain. He gives grasses, he gives water in so many ponds, like Manasi Ganga, like Kusum Sarovar, Radha Kund, Sham Kund, Man Sarovar, everywhere. So, we should try to worship Govardhan. Then, Nand Baba accepted and he told all that we should tomorrow worship Giriraj Govardhan. And in the morning, he took all the preparation in their courts, millions of courts, and all gopi, millions and millions. They went to Govardhan, where now Anore Gram.
Anore village.
And they went there and they began to worship. Krishna at once became two. One in his own form, another on the Giriraj Govardhan, he became Haridev. Like Gopal. And but with 400. No. And then he began to tell, Anore, Anore. And Krishna became priest. He offered to go Raj Govardhan and told, oh, see, Indra came ever, he gave darshan, he gave any boon, nothing. But he is selling like so. So he began to ask that, Anore, Anore, bring more preparations. In a, with two hands, he took all. And he took all the rush, water, from Manasi Ganga, everywhere he took, all came in his mouth. And then he was telling, oh, more, more, more. But Krishna told, oh, Prabhu, oh, we are very poor. We cannot give you so. Please be merciful. And then he became merciful. You can ask any boon as you like. Then what Nanda Baba and others asked boon, our Krishna should be always happy. Only this boon they asked. Then, after worshipping, oh, Indra became very. And after that they did parikrama. Those who were old, on cart, bullock carts, those who are young, oh, dancing, singing with Krishna, Baladev, all doing parikrama. They did parikrama. and when they return back to their home, he became very, very angry. And he ordered 7 clouds that just so much heavy rain, like mushladhar,
like pillar,
that press would be demolished. That is 1, 2, 3 days, and Krishna came, hearing their cry, and he lifted Govardhan at once. And all gopis, cows, came. Unlimited they were, but they came in that. And 7 days basa holo na ki? 7 days. Vajra also coming. And Govardhan was so happy that even thunderbolts were coming. Some pieces of stones were going on. But he was so happy that I am situated on the hand of Krishna. And then Indra realized, and he went in the shelter of Gavi, Surabhi. And she came, and then she prayed, Krishna became happy. This is. So if anyone is doing Govardhan, everywhere in Brajo, everywhere in India, if Govardhan not, then they will make Govardhan by cow dung, and they will worship. And also, cow play will be there, feeding cows, worshipping cows, worshipping Vaishnav, Brahman, Gurus, everyone. This is Govardhan Puja. And then Surabhi and Indra, with water what Aravat brought from Triganga, Mandakini, or Krishna, the shake was done. And the water is in Govinda Kund. And he kept this name Govinda, Govindati, Gomane Ved, Gomane Indriya, Gomane Gop, Gopi, Gabhi, all his. So his name is Govardhan. So anyone taking part, giving any preparation to him, even one grain, even he will give. Lakshmi can bake anywhere, but that person has not to bake. So even in your house you can do. Here we are doing because I am here today. But you should do on Kartik month, on Annakut day, up one day, Pratipada. First you should do puja of Gurudev, then Vaishnav, then Brahmin, then cows, then give to Govardhan, and prasadam should be distributed. Krishna bhakti will come. Now, Vardhan ki jai. We don't want anything from Krishna because he is Nand Kumar, very small boy. He cannot fulfill our. We should try to fulfill his desire. No? Or if any desire, then go to Govardhan and he will fulfill all your desire. Nand Baba, even Krishna used to go. Govardhan Tat is very high, will express any desire. Jantur bai bhava etasmin jajan yoni manu brajet tasyang tasyang salapate nipriti nipirajyate. Sukadeva Goswami is telling to Parikshit. जीव जंतु मानी जीव दिस जीव फ्रॉम बिगिनिंग ऑफ द क्रिएशन अनादि काल इज ट्रेवलिंग इन सो मेनी स्पीशीज ऑफ लाइफ एवरीवेयर वाइफ चिल्ड्रन एंड माई माइंड एवरीवेयर बट नेवर बी बिकम सेटिस्फाइड नेवर यू कैन नॉट बी सेटिस्फाइड इफ यू आर गिविंग घी इन फायर इट विल इंक्रीज सो इट विल नॉट बी कंट्रोल्ड But even that jeev, soul, if goes in the species of dog, cat, boar, hogs, and pigs, very happy, he feels very happy. Never want to give up that body. What to human persons? And he never becomes Vairagyavan, detached from worldly desires. So you don't think that, oh, this is the first time that we are doing marriage. Pigs, at a time, hundreds and thousands of wives. Your elephants, so many wives. Monkeys, you know? Budhawala, like this. So many wives. They are only, what are their duties? Eat, drink, and be married. No other things. No house. Nothing,
no job.
No shed, no job, nothing. To eat by... See, everywhere this is. Not to laugh, but to deeply think. Even we hearing and knowing and being in so many yonis, species of life. But we are not satisfied. And we are not doing bhajan. We have some love and affection. But really you keep your heart, hand in your heart, tell that I have loved more Krishna than my wife, than my children. Do you serve Krishna more than your children? You make money. How much you spend for Krishna and how much for you, your wife and your daughter and sons? How much? Then you can judge how much love and affection is for Krishna. So really, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling, oh, maya ki moh. What meaning? He is telling, oho, oho means a loss. Even they have no bhairagya. No detachment coming. And not serving Krishna. So you should all think this. And be like this. You cannot be satisfied by sexual lives. Never and never. Oh, by previous and now fruitive karma. This soul sometimes became male, sometimes become lady, sometimes napunsak. No gender. In India, we have seen so many. They are called Khoja. Kokono Devata. Souls comes from demigod, demigoddesses. Sometimes human. Or sometimes what? Like trees, creepers. If you will fail this occasion, opportunity, then you will have to go again in that. Anyone cannot save you, you must know. So determine in your heart. You cannot believe or believe, I don't know. Demigod, son of Nalkubar, and they became tree. It may be that trees were sometimes human, and again they have been trees.
Someone who has diksha, he can fall to animal species. Anyone who has gotten diksha, initiation at any time, can he also fall back?
Yes, certainly. Certainly. Anyhow, in bad association, he has left everything, guru, his bhakti, everything, and he has come in like animals, eating meat, drugs and smoking and all these things, and making aparad in the Lord's feet of bhakti and Vaishnava. Oh, he will go down. Diksha means, I think if anyone has diksha, he will not go down. There is a real incense diksha. If Dibdigyan is coming, how he can fall? I think that diksha was not appropriate, not Brahma diksha. Anusthanik diksha. Formal. We should see, in Jaiva Dharma you should see Vijay and Kumar and their diksha, they took diksha and became fan. And they saw what? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all associated, dancing and singing. Real diksha. Our diksha is generally what? Formal. Formal diksha, not formality, but formal. For Pancharatriki, to have qualification. We are not qualified. But for qualification, it is given. There is no other process. Karsnena, Tririnviksha Manishaya, Tadadhasya Kutastho Ratiratman Jato Bhave. He began to think what to do for these jivas suffering. As Krishna thinks, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Advaitacharya, you know, he was very what? For jivas. I will call Krishna that he should help them. And if he will not come, then I will destroy whole world. And he took one tulsi, three leaves, and with Ganges water, and he began to worship Krishna. Krishna satisfied. And then he came. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, one cause is that Advaitacharya called him. And in the end, thinking and thinking, then he came to conclusion. If anyone will have any attachment, any way with Krishna, especially if the rati will be in the Lord's feet of Krishna, then they may come. So, we can only be happy, not by any material things. You cannot be happy. Your lust or desiring so many with increase so much. Only accept something to maintain you. only that. And then we should have rati. Jena kena upayena krishne mano niveshaya. This I have called only for this to you all, not for anything else. Not anything. That anyhow you should have bhakti. This is our Guru Parampara idea. So I want that all you should follow these instructions. Shruti, Veda telling to Krishna, Preem. Pivanti je bhagavata atmana satam kathamritam savanaputeshu sampritam punant te visaya vidushitasayam brajant tacharna sarojasam. And Brahma is thinking that those who will chant, remember Krishna by ears, this is like a cup, two cups. Who will drink the sweet pastimes of Krishna by ears, oh, they will be soon liberated. So we should try to hear. As much as you will hear, Krishna will come in your heart and he will be like a bandhu, he will take all your everything. This is the easiest way. Parikshit Maharaj was going to die in 7 days. What he adopted? What method? Oh, I should hear. At once, when desire came, at once Mahabhagavat Sukadeva Goswami came. And in the meantime, oh, thousands and thousands of, not less than 60,000 rishis, maharshis, like Narad, Vyas, Parashar, all, so many. Okay. Then he was thinking, oh, very wonderful. This is not a course. Actually, this is boon. To see any of them, to have a darshan of these rishis, by a smaran, what becomes? All evils goes away. And now they are all here. So I don't think that it is cause. It is really benediction. Then Shrutis are telling here to attend these things, to follow these things, Sadguru Charanashe Nitanta Avashya. Sadguru Charanashya. To take shelter in a lotus feet of a Sadguru. Not Guru. Sadguru. Everywhere Sadguru. So those who have Sadguru and from him we should hear Harikatha. I think that realized Vaishnava all gurus. We think them all gurus. Especially like Siksha Guru. Diksha Guru one, but like Siksha Guru. I will come to this point how one met so many gurus. Avadhut. What was name? Dattatreya. He met 24 gurus. So we should do Siksha Guru. And their level should be somewhat, maybe gradation, but they should be sincere. Etaman lokeshmin punsam. Dharma Parashmita Bhakti Yogena tannam grahanati. Are you going to say something? Or then, Narhari, you will go to house and then bring your guitar and then
at once.
Where is your helper? Then in 1 year she will come.
Chanting the names of the Lord, chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord. Piranha Kashi Puvoskin, evil one was sin. He bargained with Lord Brahma for immortality. Not to die in the day, not to die in the night, not to die in the land, not to die in the sea, not to die by animal, not to die by man. He wanted to live eternally. Prahlad, the boy, the devotee, was son of this demon king. His father's pride and joy was he, till he heard him sing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. So mad, he tried to kill his son. Prahlad kept chanting Krishna's name, it could not be done. He threw him to demons that boiled him in oil, put him out in the wind and rain. Prahlad kept chanting Krishna's name, so it was done in vain. Hiranyakashipu then yell, Prahlad, it's your god here.
Yeah.
He struck a column with his fist, Dhanushinga appeared. It wasn't by day, it wasn't by night, it wasn't on land, it wasn't on sea, it was not by animal, it was not by man, he was killed by the supreme personality.
Thank you.
another day more. Tomorrow Krishna Kanti, what name?
Krishna
Kanta. Kanta. He should be ready here. And also Jahnava tomorrow. Then Sukadeva Goswami is telling to Parikshit, be careful and hear. Labdhva sudurlabham idam bahusam bhavante manusam arthadam manityam apihadi turnam jatet napatet anumrit tujavat nise asaya visaya sarvata khalusha. What meaning? You stand up and explain.
Srila Gurudev has asked me to explain this verse. Labdhva sudurlabhamidam bahu sambhavante. After many, many births, one has gone through many species, through animal species, plant species, and finally one has come to the human form of life. The special quality of the human form of life is that one is able to practice Krishna consciousness. One is able to realize that which is actually for one's supreme benefit. Otherwise, in animal species, ahara nidra bhayamaitunam cha, these things can be done, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending, the same as in the human form of life. So in the human form of life, one can get Sadguru, and under the guidance of Sadguru, one can take advantage. Otherwise, if one does not take advantage of the special opportunity afforded by the human form of life, there is a danger that one may again fall into the lower species of life. So therefore, it is given very emphatically, nishreyasaya, for our benefit. We must take this opportunity and not waste the human form of life by engaging in bhajan under the guidance of Sadguru.
Turnam na jatet. What is meaning of turnam na jatet?
Do not turn away, do not go down again.
Advance.
Advance.
Naturally, don't.
Advance. Don't waste a minute time. Otherwise, next moment you may die. Turnam na jatet. Patet anumittu javat nishreshaya. Sit down. What is nishreshaya? Nishreshaya. Vishaya khalu sarvasa. Turnam jatet na patet anumittu javat nishreshaya. For?
Sense gratification is available in all species
of life.
You
should stand up. What is necessary?
In the third line of the verse, it is stated, Turnam yateta napatet anumritu javan. Turnam, at once, take up the practice of Krishna consciousness. Why? Na chalet anumritu yavan. Again, you go into the chain of birth and death. One should not do this. Why? Nishreyasaya vishaya. Kalu sarvatasyat. Vishay. Sense gratification. This is not for our benefit. And that sense gratification is available everywhere. It's available everywhere without any endeavor. In other words, here Shukadeva Goswami Pad is explaining that why is it that we neglect the path of Krishna consciousness? Why? Because we have some desire for material comfort, luxury, sense gratification. Yet, all this material sense gratification, it comes by itself of its own accord without any endeavor whatsoever. on account of the karma that we performed in our previous lives. Therefore, there's no need to endeavor for that. Just endeavor for Krishna consciousness, and all those things will come anyway. And if one will neglect the endeavor for Krishna consciousness, then, oh, this will not be Shreya. This will not be for one's benefit, but it will bring about one's downfall.
What is Shreya? Oh, only Rati in the lotus feet of Krishna is Shreya. Otherwise not anything. What we are going to do in this world? Accept bhakti. All are like
cipher.
Not Shreya.
Prayer.
All are prayer. Not Shreya. Only bhakti is Shreya.
Ultimate benefit. Ultimate benefit.
Ultimate benefit. And it begins from where? Sadhu Sangha. Then Shraddha comes. Shraddha, two kinds of Shraddha. From beginning. Hearing Shastra. Lobhamayi. Another, by hearing Shastra, and it is our duty by this. Lomai Shraddha, gradually it comes in Raganuga. And Vaidhi Bhakti, Aishwarya Bhakti. When Raganuga Bhakti will come, oh, this is necessary. Vaidhi Bhakti also not so much. Hi, Shreya. But nirseshaya, only this Raganuga Bhakti. So, turnam jate tana patet. Before dying, time is not certain. Parikshit Maharaj is 7 days. But we know, just we are here, we may go out and we may go die. Here also, no certainty. In a moment, it may. So, those who are wise, intelligent, they should begin from there. Don't be weak. It is easy to say. Easy to say. But very
hard
to
practice.
So we should try to practice it. Again, Sukadeva Goswami is telling, Ayu harati vai punsaṁ uddhanastanta jannasau tasyarte jatkhano nita uttam sloka vartaya. Selected a slokas by Srimad Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Ayu harati vai punsaṁ. Can you explain? You?
So Sukadeva Goswami is quoting this sloka. Ayu harati vai punsam uddhanastanta jannasau tasyaiti yacchano nita uttam sloka vartaya. We have seen, or we are seeing every day, sun is rising and then setting. So, and who has taken birth, they must have to die one day. But what he did in his human lives, you have to consider about that. Ayu harati vai punsam. Ayu means lifetime. Stolen by whom? And whose? Vai punsam. Punsam means all living entities. Ayu harati vai punsam. Uttanastra jannaso. Every day sun is rising and setting, day and night. By this way, sun is stealing our lifetime. Then how we can extract from this? Tastaitaja chano nito uttam sloka vartaya. If we discuss among ourselves the glory of uttam sloka. Uttam sloka means by uttam uttam sloka, by very beautiful, beautiful sloka, to whom we pray, then in uttam sloka. Actually uttam sloka name of is Krishna. So if we pray Krishna by very beautiful sloka, like selected slok of Srimad Bhagavatam, which you have heard from Siddha Gurudev Lotus Leaf, Tastreja Chanitabhya, which time we will spend discussing Harikatha, then our life will be successful. That time, Surya cannot, sun cannot steal from us. And if you not do so, then our life will go vain. And if we, when we meet together, each other, if we discuss Harikatha, then our life will not be waste. If we not do so, then we have to suffer. And if we do so, then next birth, we'll get more higher birth and more higher sadhu sangha. And gradually, where Mahaprabhu's pastime is going on, after that, where Krishna's pastime is going on, we'll take birth there and we'll do bhajan, higher and higher bhajan. Then one day we'll attend the associateship of Sriman Mahaprabhu and Divine Couple, Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Bansha Prabhupada. You have heard this story. Two rats cutting two branches, here day and night, but comes from sun. Oh, he is cutting our lifetime. I don't know how many days are still, or how many hours, or how many moments, but he is cutting. Only he cannot cut those who are chanting and remembering Krishna, not the artist. So, Srinivata Shraddhaya, Nityam Gnatasya Swacheshitam Nati Dirghen Kalin Bhagavan Vishadehuti, Pravishta Karnarandhena Svanang Bhava Sarururaham Duno Tishamalam Krishna Salilam Jathasarat. Who will explain? Bhakti Shar? Oh, you? What? It has been explained?
No.
Srinivatam Sadhanitam Grinathas Chaswachastitam Nathde Kalina Mata Bhagavan Vishatharidhi. In this verse, Sri Sukadeva Goswami explains to Parikshit Maharaj, you must do five things, then your spiritual life will be successful. Srinivatam, first you have to hear. Sri Gauga Maharaj used to ask, who is hearing? All are not hearing. All is going in one ear and out the other. Hearing is an art. Unless one is completely surrendered, how can one hear? Srinivatam, Sradaya. One must hear with faith. Nityam, continuously. Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya. Every day one must make an effort to hear the Srimad Bhagavatam. Grinatas. Everything we hear we have to accept. Not like filtering. I like this, but I don't like that. And most importantly, but most difficult, Chasva Chastitam. One must, everything one hears and accepts with faith, Chasva Chastitam. One must practice and endeavor in one's own life. Nadadi Kalena Mataha. One who does these five things in no time at all, Bhagavan Vishatadadi, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, will manifest in his heart.
Thank you. Srinivata Shraddhaya. Here, importance of Shraddha. If you are Shraddha, very easy. Hearing what? What difficulty? Problem. But there should be Shraddha. And if you have Shraddha and hearing, then by Shramani, hearing, at once, without delay, here he tells that Alpa Kaler Madhya, after some days, after some time. But in the beginning, Sukadeva Goswami has told Bhagavate Mahamuni Krite Kimba Pare Rishwari Sadhya Avaruddhate Atra Kritibi Susuvi Tatkhanat. What is the meaning Tatkhanat?
Immediate.
So how wonderful. So we should hear Harikatha. We want to hear Vishayakatha. Instead of that, we should hear Harikatha with Shraddha. in no moment, at once, Krishna will come in your heart. And what he will do as a laukik bandhu? Karna randhena swanang bhava saruruham. Bhava saruruham, bhava is like lotus. Dhunoti shamalam. He takes away, wash
out
all the worldly desires, aparadh, anartha, everything. So only Shraddha is needed. Here, what you have here with Shraddha, Krishna will go in your heart and do everything. Khatvango Rama Raja. Vishnu Tve. You have Muhurtam Sarvam Utsrijya Gatvan Abhayanghari. So as a Khatvanga Rishi.
Rajarshi.
Who went to Swargalok, heaven, to fight with demons. He defeated them. And the son of Shankar, Kartikeya, now he became general.
Commander general.
And the demigods told that we are very happy. You can have any boon.
And you can stay here forever.
You should have any boon. He told that I want liberation and to serve Krishna. Oh, that we cannot give. Then if you cannot give, then I have nothing to
ask
any boon for you. Please
tell me how
many days or how many years I will. Oh, only 12 minutes or
24 minutes.
Oh, take me to earth in Vrindavan anywhere. And he brought him. At once he dedicated fully to Krishna. And in moment, Sarvam Utsrijya means?
Give up everything.
He gave up everything what he has. He has big kingdom, wife, children, attachment for them, everything. He cut it and he sat and
meditated
and at once, in a moment, he went. So there are so many examples. Parasparam, parasparanu kathanam, pamanam bhagavat jasah. Mitho rati, mitho tushti, nibhriti, mitha atmana, smaranta, smaranantascha, mitho agha, haram, harim, bhaktya, sanjata, bhaktya, vibhut, utpat, kalyatana. Oh, about the jiva conditioned soul, they should follow bhakti. Vaidhi bhakti. Raganuga bhakti is very rare. Very rare. We should not try to pretend that I am Raganuga. They should follow bhakti. And by this, especially in our sampradaya, Gaudiya Vaishnava sampradaya, reading Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Though it appears Vaidhi bhakti, but very soon it will bring Raganuga. So, we should follow Vaidhi Bhakti. From Vaidhi Bhakti will come Bhava Bhakti. What is sadhana? We should know. What we are doing all, not sadhana. We are chanting, remembering, without aim. Oh, Krishna Prema will come. No. What is sadhana bhakti? Kriti sadhya bhava, sa sadhana vidha, nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatam ridhi sadhyata. What meaning?
Microphone, please.
Srila Gurudeva needs to speak about this verse of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Manifested by Srila Rupa Goswami Pada, it is Paribhasha, the definition of sadhana.
He's saying, Kriti Sadhya Bhavet Sadhya Bhavasa Sadhanabhida. Kriti means by the senses. When our senses are engaged in the angas of bhakti, such as hearing, chanting, and remembering, in what way? Kriti Sadhya Bhavet Sadhya Bhava. In such a way that the Sadhya Bhav, or the goal of our life, will be attained, then sadhana abhida. This is called sadhana. What is the potentiality of sadhana? We should know that the goal of our life is to attain bhav bhakti. For those who are conditioned in this world, their aim and object is bhav bhakti. Rati, that is one of five types. One permanent foundational emotional relationship with Krishna, either in Santa Dasya Sakyavatsali or Madhurya, especially in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami, in Madhurati is the aim and objective. So when hearing and chanting and remembering, that means the senses of this body and the mind are engaged in the process of devotion with the aim and object of attaining Sadhya Bhav, that goal, Krishna Rati, then this is called sadhana. So nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatyamriti sadhyata. What is the potentiality of this practice? The potentiality is that nitya siddha bhav, one mood which is eternally perfect and hidden. This is our real treasure. Hidden within the heart, prakatyamriti sadhyata, it should become manifest. Therefore, if a devotee is hearing, chanting and remembering, but they have no idea what is the aim and object, what is Krishna Rati, or what type of Krishna Rati, then their practice can never be called sadhana bhakti. Therefore, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained that, oh, when the jiva is anatagrasta, he's covered by so many anatas, his hearing, chanting, remembering is not sadhana, it is sadhana abhas. When anatas are clearing, some steadiness will come, little taste will come, ruchi, at that time he understands bhakti tattva. Yatra alpa ruchir eva syad bhakti tattva avabodhikaha. If a little ruchi will come, then he understands bhakti tattva, and then he can think very nicely, oh, what is the goal of my life? And try very hard to attain that goal through guru seva, vaishnava seva, and very intensely hearing, chanting, and remembering. Oh, this will be actual sadhana bhakti to begin from there.
Very good. What is bhav bhakti? By sadhan bhakti, we can attain bhav bhakti. But what is really bhav bhakti? Shuddha sattva, visheshatma, prema surjans samyabhat, ruchibhi chittam masin, kridasau. Shuddha sattva, oh, very. Shuddha Sarv Sattva means the mood of Radhika or Gopis. Or Brajabasi you can tell. But highest in Gopis and Radhika. How he loves Krishna, this mood. And by following them, that mood partly comes to heart of devotees. That is called Shuddha Sattva. But Visheshatma, what is Visheshatma? That mood, two things, Samved and Hladini. Sar, essence of both. Bhav, bhav you know? What means bhav?
Bhav, transcendental emotion.
I don't think so, but there is no any word for bhav. Prema sanjan susamyabha. Essence of both. Hladini and Sambit. On Sambit. Sandini, our heart. When it descends, then it is called Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma. This is the prem sujjan susambhava. If prem is surya, oh, little part of that. Abhas.
Semblance.
Semblance. then it is wrong. What it does? Ruchi bhi. Chittamal. What ruchi? Ruchi here?
There's such kind of bhagavat.
Abhilasha. Krishna ko prapt karne ki abhilasha jo hai.
Bhagavat prapt abhilasha, anukul abhilasha, sohat
abhilasha. Sohat ityati. These are. And then, chit becomes.
Very smooth.
Smooth and melting. That is called rati or bhav. So, our mood should be that. How by sadhan we can attain, manifest that bhav. If you are doing chanting, remembering, but mood is there, our goal is there, then it will come. And when bhav bhakti will come, then our mood will be to attain prema. These are processes. But how it will come? Very easy method. Parasparanu kathanam pavanam bhagavat jasah mitho rati mitho bhakti tushti nivritti atmana smananta smaranta bhagavat jas. The glories of Krishna, sweet pastimes of Krishna, each other telling and hearing. When two bhakts are there, having the same mood, then whole day and night, like Rup and Sanatan, like Mahaprabhu Rai Ramananda, like Srinivas Pandit, whole night doing kirtan, no sleepness, like this, paraspar, each other doing. What? Any devotee told, Krishna is very merciful. Another told, Radha is so merciful.
Like Sukhsari.
May I tell something? Oh yes, I want to hear. Once Krishna, in the form of an Ashpara.
Angels.
Angels.
Heavenly damsel.
She came to Javat Gram, where Radhika was sitting. With her sakhis. Sakhis. And in form of a very sham color. Very beautiful.
Attractive.
Sham sakhi. Attracting all. She came. And then Radhika saw, who is coming? Who is coming? Then, other Sakhi, I don't know. I am seeing first time. Very Mohini Murti.
Very attractive form.
Very attractive. Radhika stood up and welcomed. Come on, I have never seen you. From where you came? You look like angel. And he gave a seat. And then he sat down there. And then Radhika told, who are you? Why have you come? And why you have come? But she was silent. And then, are you lamenting anything? Why you are so sad?
What is your problem?
You should tell, I will make any remedy. And if any so much suffering, that in by telling others it will be subside somehow. But not even this. Perhaps your husband is not good, not qualified. So I have no love for him. So what to do? Perhaps you don't like her and you have some friendship with another, any boyfriend, perhaps. So that is the problem. But she was great, not in telling anything.
Radhika Das Swami Ji told me, "Our Baba, the tail party, she loved. Kono dukho to kori tail
party." Oh, then Radhika told, "Oh, she is perhaps any headache or anything pain,
pain in his body,
and that is why she is not speaking. Bring my father has given a very
good massage.
Mahanarayan tail." It cures anyone and he becomes very happy. Oh, I will rub his. Because she is my sakhi. Even she is not speaking. And what became after? Oh, tomorrow. So these are Parsparam. Very mysterious and very wonderful sweet Parsparam. Very soon you can read it. I will give it in a form of a publication. How interesting. So these pastimes, like Rupa and Sanatani, used to each other. So when two devotees will meet together, they will discuss all these things. So this is Mitho Rati. Mithatusti Nivartisya Atmana Smaranam Smarayancha. By these past sweet pastimes of Krishna. Oh, they remember Krishna and Radhika and sweet pastimes of Krishna. Each other hearing by questioning. What became after that? Oh, and after that, like this. So we should follow all these things. You see that you will forget worldly desires and worldly all these wishes.
That anyone can play the role of this Bhaktivinoda Thakur Bharti as we really all become overwhelmed. All were weeping. They were also, especially her part. So my special blessing, you should try to develop a prem like Babaji and prem Das. And behave like, oh, what Pradyumna Mishra Babaji. He told his disciples what behavior was it. My blessing to you especially. But I think others also played very good role. Very good. These six four. The play. Sakhis. I thought that as it is, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is playing like this, all with me. So my heartly blessings to you. You follow Jaiva Dharma, relation to Guru like Jaiva Dharma, and process how he was meditating and Krishna first time came. And in trance he told his disciple then, O Raman Manjari, stop that.
Monkey.
not to disturb Radha Krishna.
Pastime.
So my heartly blessing. Go. My heartly blessing.
Yeah. I'm happy to be here.
Oh, Gurdy, that's a wonderful plan. So she looks forward to the next installment.
You're making us come back tomorrow. Every day we have to come back for more.
I remember always. My pilot, my pilot.
Gurudev, this is Nancy. She's thank you for translating Jivadharma. Those girls inspired me to read it again.
Shankar from Canada. What's in
his name? Hey, down.
And he said at the border, he said, I'm coming to see Narayan Maharaj. And the border man said, okay, you can come.
He said, oh, Narayan.
Gurudev, this is Nancy, also from Canada. She's coming for the first time.
In training or classes?
Yes.
Okay. This rigor and love of this disciple, the conditional that is the sense conditional in the sense that he'll love him as much as you fell. Yes. This is Mahadrani from the Mathura. Please give me your mercy that I can arrange my life to please you. Thank you, Gurudev.
Good classes.
Very first class.
You were thinking of me.
Yes.
I do.
Thank you.
death for Krishna.
Tomorrow,
we will meet tomorrow.